summer camp. Raise your hand. Oh, great. Very good. And this club, that is club that I am charge of, this is the club that is collaborating with Center for Peace to do so many programs, so many. And one of that is that we are going to sponsor so many of you if you like to collaborate with UNESCO as ambassadors.
Art and craft. How do you say art?
craft. It's better to give it to the frontal. How do you say art and craft in your language? Arte and Meridales.
Okay.
Now, I am going to show you a video clip that explains better everything, and then I ask questions. United Nations Educational Scientific Cultural Organization that was born in November 16, 1945 to bring peace and justice around the world through all the scientific cultural organizations and the together of the people of any race, sex, religion to talk and create this inter-dialogue. We are part of the U.S. National Federation of UNESCO. What we do is about the three goals that we have. One of them is how to protect and support ecosystem, this Mother Earth, and all the nature around us. Another goal or vision statement is how to support and encourage art and culture that can give job also again to other people and bring more and more dignity to those people who have some talent, potential, ability, but they never can express themselves. The last but not the least is how we can help the individual, healthier people through all kinds of disciplines.
I work as a physical therapist, and I really appreciate having the UNESCO Body Mind Wellness Club available to me and, of course, for others to have that availability. I find that the aspects that they emphasize in areas of nutrition, soft yoga, and meditation are really beneficial for myself personally. And I also find that this is something that I can use in my practice. And for example, the nutritional aspect, I talk about healthy, balanced eating habits. And that's so important for me to incorporate it with my patients. And then, of course, there's the area of meditation where you can go within yourself and really feel introspective and feel de-stressed and feel more aware of your environment and more focused and more balanced and more peaceful. And there's one area that they emphasize for meditation, which is called the Hatha meditation. I find that one particularly beneficial for me because it works on your own innate inner energy or chi energy or kundalini energy, which does the work for you in the meditation.
Recently, we had a very beautiful festival. We created a momentum for all the artists come on the stage, from puppet show to Kathak dance to some folkloristic music. We could bring really good samples of different countries. Our club is truly a multicultural, biodiversity aspect of this club is everywhere, but it is not only through art and craft, health and supporting with a different view and technique, the ecosystem, the Mother Earth and ecology, but also through having fun. So many workshops we do, such as how to make a beautiful felted soap or some handicraft for children, but also about the food. Through the food, different fragrances, aroma, taste, we can bring our palate to that unity. We dedicate some time and tables, exhibition to different cuisines and dishes from around the world.
One of our future projects that we are working on is to bring small workshops for little children to local libraries and elementary schools. So recently a club published a book titled If I Could, and we did some animation based on that book. So we were thinking to organize like 1 hour reading session that will include puppet show, that will include work with the clay and work with the animation, as well as book reading. All of this activity will focus on giving children knowledge of peace, knowledge of collaboration, and knowledge of love.
As a member of the UNESCO Body, Mind, Wellness Club, I'm privy to the different activities that are going to be held in the future. And one of them is the celebration of Yoga Day, which is on June 21st. And I'm excited about that because it's going to be offering and incorporate, hopefully, the real benefits of yoga, which really means union or oneness with that all-pervading connectedness with nature, with harmony and balance. And so that will be bring more attention to yoga in its true essence and awareness of what it really is. Sattva meditation will be presented as one of the platforms for really experiencing that deeper essence of what yoga means and what it can offer us as human beings.
For the future, we want to create a synthesis of all the experiences that we have in our personal life, our job, and these programs that we do through our UNESCO club. It means that we want to bring together artists, vendors, and those momentum that can give more a deep relationship of how we can connect with the responsibility at international level. How to bring that biodiversity of understanding each other, dialogue for peace.
We have been in Iran, and there we can imagine with all that situation, I don't know how many people know about Iran. Do you know where it is? Iran, raise your hand if you know. Okay, wow, thank you. 2 years ago, we have 4 ambassadors like you, and they won the best prizes of Tesla and on a point. But unfortunately, because of the governmental situation this year and last year, they couldn't make it. So we went to them. We went to them to give them the prizes and to let them know that we love them and we don't forget about them. So in this moment, you can see that we gave this prize to them and invited them for the next future webinar. They are always with us. And we did so many projects also through the competition of Tesla, the light, internationally that you can participate. Please keep an eye on that. We take care of the green architecture because I am an architect, green architect, and we try to make conferences, especially for those countries like Spain, in African countries that they have so much sun, we can go through geothermal and through the solar panels. And also the wind power. So if you are available to work on these areas of sustainability, please send me a message or come here, I take your name. Doesn't mean that you have to be here. I can sponsor you with Mr. B. Joken, but it doesn't mean that you have to be here. We can work through internet and you send me all your ideas. We have beautiful competition in this area also. Renewable energy and sustainability, that always about how to reduce our carbon footprint, not only recyclable, but also how to make the artwork, you know, and creating beautiful urbanistic areas and houses or offices with less energy consumption. If you have any idea or project, please again come to me and ask for a sponsorship. We work on hydroponics. Until last year, we had a session on hydroponics. So that is the way for those countries who don't have so much water, how to grow vegetables and even trees with very little water. With no soil. Inner energy we talk about, it is about always having inner peace inside. And then we have this nexus energy. Nexus means nectar. Nexus means nectar. Means that energy between all the trees, the sap of the tree. And in each one of us exists a nexus, or that kundalini. That if we can work with it, we become so respectful toward ourselves first, and naturally, automatically toward Mother Earth. So we have beautiful nature adventure. We have a group of volunteers. For example, this video and this website is done with one of you as a volunteer. She was from Belgium, and she came and helped us in so many areas. This morning I have a meeting with one very young guy of 17 years old that is helping us with the nature adventure. You can do it in your countries. It doesn't have to be here, but be connected, networking with us. So I am going to ask the next one. What does it mean? Pass it, somebody. What does it mean, Nexus? Nexus, pass it to somebody. That is the hard work, no? Of networking, creating peace around the world. To be patient, to be attentive about what is going on. How do you say, what does it mean, Nexus? Nexus. It's kind of energy, it's okay, it's enough. Another project that we are doing with the city, another project with the city of Frederick is about the business department of this food college, and not only, also with FCC, Frederick Community College. We have a sort of conferences, seminars on the business holders that they use very, very intelligent way, ecologic way, without harming this Mother Earth in their choices. If you have ideas of your own business and you don't have maybe any idea about how to be eco-friendly, please contact us. We put you on the list and we can organize webinars, conferences online for you. Or if you have your own business and it is eco-friendly, you are more than welcome to collaborate with us for everybody else around the world. Art and culture. As you can see, we have a competition in the area of filmmaking, photography, painting, poetry, and music. This competition is open. It is until, I think, mid of August. You can participate. You can go to the conditions of transmitting your art job. And so with that, you have the possibility to have different prizes. One of the most important ones is the becoming a member of UNESCO. With that, you can participate in all the international galleries of UNESCO and talk about your ideas, not only at the network level, but also in the physical level at the conference that can be in Paris or can be in Milano, somewhere. So please go to the website and check and see if you can present some of your artwork for that competition. We have also open mic that gives opportunity every second Thursday of the month. We have different artists coming, singing, reciting their poetry, presenting their artwork. And here, this is the book, If I Could, that was presented in one library. Here, again, an open mic in our office in Frederick. It is in downtown Frederick, West Patrick Street. You can always come to ask me if you stay here. Otherwise, you can connect through webinar, internet, somehow. And then we had other kind of artists participating. They were from Boston, they were from Italy. Ted, the theater of Eternal Value, made a beautiful job, like a sort of movable theater, going around different areas of United States and presenting art of different cultures. And always about the theme of UNESCO and inner peace. Here you can see the clay making Okay, how do you say clay in your language? Who has the clay in your language? Yeah. How do you say clay in your language? It's a mud, no? It's a soil with water. Plastilina. And as you see, here we have a display in our UNESCO center. You can display your art. We can even sell those arts for you, those crafts for you. We have translated so to the paintings, to the centerpieces, tablecloths, all kinds, bags, flowers, done with silk. Not only selling them, but also if you can teach a group of two or three people the same art, you can have the logo of UNESCO behind your artwork. Have you seen the UNICEF logo and the postcard, right? Have you seen, how many people have seen UNESCO, UNICEF logo and the postcard? You know what does it mean? It means that that is not only an artwork, but it is a connection around the world. And for that reason, people are ready to pay much more money because they feel to be part of a greater organization and for a very good purpose. So we do the same with your artwork, not only helping you economically, but also giving you this opportunity to display your artwork at the international level and become part of the UNESCO network. And here are the scarf, felted soap, all kind of stuff. Dolls. These dolls are very safe for little children because they have no stitches. They are all one piece. Bags. They are all the cultural exhibitions with crafters. These are our theatrical exhibitions, presentations, again, painting for the piece through the schools, making pasta, making our own food, making the dance through the movement, finding this inner energy inside us. Poems, nights, aprons, clays. I go fast because we don't have so much time. And then these are the seminars with all kinds of physicians, people who work at the universities. They come and bring us their knowledge.
Okay.
How many people would like to be part of the ecosystem or ecology project? Raise your hand, please. Okay. That means not only working with the alternative energy technologies, but also hanging out not only here in Frederick, but also in your countries, but be connected. Put down your hands, please. How many people would like to be part of the art and craft project? That doesn't mean only bringing your art, but competitions that are open for you. And also you can send your pieces in small boxes where somebody comes and brings it for you and we display. And if you can create sort of workshop in a group for 2 years, you can have the logo of UNESCO behind your work. Okay? Thank you. Now, self-awareness. This is the this is familiar to you, no? Under the pergola, we did a beautiful experience of meditation. Inner peace bring outward peace. And then last year we had the same experience. Here we did so many seminars and conferences about how to use our inner energy at the medical level to use it as a prevention against any kind of diseases, mental and physical. It's very important. There are so many studies, especially in NIH, National Institute of Health, that is in Bethesda, that if you want, I can send you very good articles about the veins and how these veins work on your body and mind. A stress relief meditation we have 3 times a week in our center, but that also through internet and connection internationally. In each country you can find a center, or you can find an online guided meditation. So there is no excuses that you can't take care of your health, or online in your country, or physically go to your center. There is a very good project from Italy. It started in Italy. That is called Inner Peace Day. Imagine, in that country of so much of heart and artwork, they understood that how it's important to find that art within. And now the government of Italy gave authorization to the Saggio Yoga Meditation to do in the very beautiful palaces in Rome, Milano, Torino, everywhere, in the schools and in those palaces, to invite people to come and do this kind of self-awareness inner peace day. It is not only, it started in one day, but then it is spread as every day in every school and every institution and office. Okay, let's see your network now, how it works. Are you happy with your network yet? It is loose in some area, it is not homogeneous. It means that you are not in tune with each other. Please make it a beautiful. Can you take a photo, please, of this beautiful network? And this is really about the mind wellness. And I am more than happy now to answer some of your questions. And at the very end, please come to give me your phone number or take my phone number, email address, website. Any question? Yes. Yes. It's about how to rise this energy, no? From Australia, Etanea, Bhagavana. I am working with my energy. I am rising my nourishment. And then when you do this, it's like celebrating life. I am one as a microcosm with macrocosm with all together. Two. Not, yes.